Hello and welcome to the session in which we will discuss the concept of goodwill. What is the big idea? Well, goodwill is created when one company purchases another company, paying a price in excess of the fair market value of the identifiable asset. Simply put, we have company A and company B. Company A purchases company B, and the fair market value, we're going to go a little bit in details about this, is $100,000 for company B. However, company A, for some reason, paid, for example, $150,000. Well, they paid $50,000 in excess of the fair market value of company B. Now, this is the basic idea, but we're going to have to look at more details information. The first thing you need to know about goodwill is it's not internally generated. There's no internally generated goodwill. In other words, it only happens when one company A purchases another company B. It's considered to have an indefinite life intangible asset. So it's an intangible asset. It lacks physical existence. You cannot touch goodwill, but it has an indefinite life. What does that mean? Well, what we learned in intangible asset, that indefinite life intangibles, they're not subject to amortization. We don't amortize them. And the reason is simple, because they have an indefinite life. To amortize something, it means to expense it over the period in which it contribute cash flow. Well, if the period for this goodwill is indefinite, therefore there's no limited amount of time. Therefore, we don't amortize goodwill. Now, goodwill is subject to amortization. Subject to impairment, not amortization. Now, certain companies, smaller companies, they might be subject to special rules about goodwill, but we're not going to go into this discussion. The best way to illustrate the concept of goodwill is to actually look at a simple example. Let's assume Adam Agricultural Company decided to diversify its risk, so it's an agricultural company, by buying 100% of Drone Inc. It's a drone company. And Adam Company paid $415,000. So we're going to look at this company and try to illustrate the concept of goodwill. We're going to start by looking at the drone company balance sheet. This is what they have on their balance sheet in terms of assets. They have cash, account receivable, inventory, property, plant, and equipment, total assets of $303,000. So cash, $36,000, account receivable, $42,000, inventory, $55,000, property, plant, and equipment. On their liability sides, they have current liabilities of $60,000, common stock of $100,000, retained earnings of $143,000, liabilities plus equity equal to 103, they should equal to the assets. So this is the balance sheet based on the book value or the accounting figures of the company. Well, when you buy a company, what you have to do is you have to compute the fair value of their assets and the fair value of their liabilities in order to find out what is the amount of the goodwill to determine whether you have a goodwill or you don't have a goodwill. You might have something else. You might have what's called a bargain purchase. Before we look over the fair value, I would like to remind you, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. I can help you understand the material better. I explain the theory behind the concept. I go a little bit slower than your CPA review course. I give you additional resources, multiple choice, CPA questions. That's going to help you understand the concept better, which will help you with your CPA review material. Your risk with me is 1 month of subscription. That's your commitment. You try it, you like it, you keep the subscription. It's from month to month. If not, you cancel. Your potential gain is improving your score and passing your CPA exam. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university is doing on the CPA exam. This is a list of all my accounting courses, including intermediate, advanced accounting, governmental, where I have lectures, multiple choice questions and exercises that's going to help you learn the material better. My CPA review material is aligned with your Becker, Roger, Wiley, and Gleam, so it's very easy to go back and forth between your review course, your main course, and your supplemental material. I also give you access to 1,500 plus previously AI CPA released questions with detailed solution. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So now we're going to examine the fair value of the assets and the fair value of the liabilities. The cash fair value, so the book value, we have $36,000 in cash. Well, the fair value of cash is usually the same unless we have some foreign currency. Account receivable, we expect to receive $42,000. And the fair value of it is $42,000. Inventory will be different. Inventory on the books is $55,000. but the inventory is worth $86,000, and that's usually true because the inventory, you sell it for more than its cost. Property, plant, and equipment on the books is $170,000. Property, plant, and equipment fair value is $210,000. That's always the case if you have property, plant, and equipment, especially buildings. They might go up in value, or land, usually. Now, what we did is we identified another asset that was not on the balance sheet of Drone Inc. initially. So notice here, we just added an asset. We find out that they have a patent, and that patent is worth $20,000. You might be saying, how come why don't Drone Inc., which is a drone company, don't have that patent on their balance sheet? And the reason is simple. That patent might be internally created. So if you create a patent internally, you cannot record it. Or if you record, it's a small amount. So simply put, we identified this patent because it's internally created. Now we are purchasing the patent. Now it's part of our assets. So it's identified. Notice the fair market value of identifiable asset. Now it's an identifiable asset. Then we have liabilities. We're going to assume it has the same market rate as the book value. Now if we take the assets, take all the assets minus the liabilities, we find out that the fair value of the company is $334,000. Hold on a second. If the fair value of the net asset, which is assets minus liabilities, equal to $334,000, why are you paying $415,000? Simply put, why are you paying the extra? Well, the extra, you are paying the extra, it could be for many reasons. It could be the reputation of the company, the management of the company, the location of the company. It could be that Adam Agriculture went into a bidding war with another company, and Adam really wanted to buy Drone Inc. It's the ego of the management of the agricultural company. It doesn't matter. For some reason, we paid extra, and we cannot pinpoint why we paid the extra. Now, we know we paid $20,000 extra for this. So what does that mean? It means we paid $415,000. Well, the book value of the company, let me show you what the book value of the company is. The book value of the company is $243,000, which is common stock and retained earning, which is the net equity of the company, because assets, $303,000 minus $60,000, which is assets minus liability. This is all book number. So if we take $303,000 minus $60,000, it's going to give us $243,000. $243,000 is really the book value, of the equity. So simply put, for this $415,000, the first $243,000 we paid for the book value. Then of the $415,000, we paid for the amount above the book value. For example, we paid for the difference between receivable, the difference between inventory 55 and inventory 56 of 86. So if we take 86 minus 55, we paid $31,000 extra for the inventory, for the fair value of the inventory. And for the property, plant, and equipment, the book value was $170,000 and the fair value was $210,000. We paid an additional, so if we take $210,000 minus $170,000, we paid an additional $40,000 for property, plant, and equipment. Then we identified a patent worth $20,000. So let's see, if we take the $415,000, we paid for the book value $243,000. That's going to bring us down to $172,000. Then we allocated $31,000 to the inventory. We allocated $40,000. We allocated $40,000 to the property, plant, and equipment, and we allocated $20,000 to the patent. Well, if we allocated those $415,000 to all of this, what's going to be left with? We're going to be left with $81,000 that we cannot allocate to anything. Well, if we cannot allocate to anything, guess what we're going to call it? We're going to call it goodwill. Now we identified, we're going to put a new asset called goodwill. So simply put, what we can do is we can take $415,000 minus the fair market value, fair value of the net asset, $334,000. But notice what I did. I took the $415,000 and I broke it down for you, what we paid for. We paid for the book value of the company. We paid for the extras for the inventory value, the extras for the property, plant, and equipment, the extra for the $20,000 property patent that was not identified. And what's left is our goodwill. Or you can take what we paid versus the fair value of net asset. This is what I started with, what I told you. It's what we pay in excess of the fair value. Now let's look at the journal entry to see how this all works. So now we purchased this company. We're going to debit cash $36,000. We're going to debit account receivable $42,000. So we're going to put everything on the books based on the fair value because we purchased them. This is cost for us. Inventory is $86,000. Property, plant, and equipment $210,000. Patent $20,000. We paid $415,000. We bring the liabilities as well. And what's left to balance is an account called Goodwill of $81,000. So this is what Goodwill is. Goodwill is an intangible. Remember, it is an intangible. It's not amortized because it's considered to have an indefinite life. Now, what happens if we pay for this company rather than $334,000? We paid $300,000. What would happen? What would change? Well, if we paid $300,000 for a company that's worth $334,000, well, the cash cannot be $415,000. The cash will be $300,000. Obviously, we will not have goodwill because we paid less than the fair value. So what would happen under those circumstances to make the entry balance? Not to make the entry balance. What happened is we have a gain. We have a gain. We purchased. We had a purchase bargain. And we have a gain of $34,000, which is the difference between what we paid and the fair value of the net asset of the company. So make sure there is no negative goodwill. We have a gain. Now, the best way to learn about goodwill is to work additional multiple choice questions. Now, bear in mind, this topic is covered more in advanced accounting. So you want to know more about goodwill in your advanced accounting course, but this is for intermediate accounting. This is good enough. At the end of this recording, once again, I'm going to remind you, whether you are a student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition. I can help you understand the material better. You're going to study for your exam, for your accounting career once in your lifetime. Make the right investment. My subscription will not break you. It's just going to make you a little bit stronger. It's going to help you understand the material. Make this investment. It will pay you dividend down the road. The CPA exam is worth it. Good luck, study hard, and of course, stay safe.